Greetings all, welcome to my video. From CollectiveEvolution.com. An open letter to the Illuminati bloodline families. By Joe Martino. The facts. The Illuminati is a set of families, whose reign in power over humanity is traceable for centuries. A being by the name of Adamu, has allegedly channeled this message through a channel named Zing Dad. Reflect on. Have you explored the truth of these bloodlines and their power? Do you find yourself aware of these truths, but angry and hate-filled about them? Have you recognized the spiritual journey involved in this uncovering process? Whether you call it the Cabal, Illuminati, the Deep State, or the Elite, much attention has been placed on the traceable family bloodlines that have been running our world for centuries. Imagine a family heirloom passed down from generation to generation, only this one is power over the entire planet. But this power is coming to an end for these families, as we are becoming more and more aware of their reign and manipulation over our planet. This is very much a spiritual journey for us, as it is for them, as we are all tied to the oneness consciousness, or source, that is everything. I have always talked about the elite, deep state, Illuminati, as a spiritual subject. Many spiritual people like to view this subject in a negative light, and claim that it shouldn't be talked about, as if talking about it gives it more power and keeps it in place. This could not be further from the truth. Remaining ignorant to it, and not shining a light on it, will keep it in place. What I do understand is, if one becomes angry, judgmental, and obsessive, over-searching through conspiracies, does not process what is taking place, and ends up mentally stuck in a conspiratorial loop, then yes, this is unhealthy, and will create fear that will hold certain things in place. So in simple terms, we must know how to consciously move through these truths, share them, and learn from them, without getting caught up in all of the fear and emotion that may come with it. I talk about how this is a necessary process in a recent episode of the CE podcast linked in the description below. A letter. I came across an interesting letter that was allegedly channeled through a person called Zing Dad. The being coming through claims to be Adamu, of the Pleiadian civilization. Pleiadians are one of many ET races that have been interacting with humanity for many years. I found this channeling to be fairly insightful and resonant with many of the understandings I have come to find or discover within through my journey over the years. So I decided to share it here. With any channeling, I always say, don't get caught up so much in whether or not it's in fact channeled by an entity or being, or whether or not it's entirely true, but see what in here resonates, how it feels, whether or not it rings true deeply, versus just in the mind. As beings, we are meant to discern truth through the heart and mind working together, not simply one or the other. So perhaps before reading, take a moment to quiet the mind, breathe into the heart and then continue onward. Begin channel. Greetings my friends. I am Adamu, of the monadic entity of the Pleiadian civilization, brought to you through Zing Dad. Today I will be addressing the living members of the ancient bloodline families. Those ones who are sometimes called by other names such as the Illuminati, the powers that be, the ruling elite, the Cabal, and a few other, less charitable, terms that I shan't mention. To be clear, I am not now addressing the rich and powerful, who regularly appear in the press. Political leaders, religious leaders, and the heads of multinational corporations are not the ones who truly run planetary affairs. These are people who come and go with time. And, when required, they always bow to the far greater power, wielded by the ones I now speak of. But, be that as it may, the bloodline family members know who they are. And it is they whom I address today. Though I do suspect that this open letter will be of great interest to many others besides. It is intended, especially, that star seeds and light bringers take note of this communique. So here it begins, an open letter to the members of the ancient bloodline families. My dear friends, I must begin by saying that you are seen, known, understood, and loved. Just as you are, right here and right now, you are loved. Perhaps it will surprise you to hear me say this? There is so much judgment of you wherever one goes, is there not? You are labeled as dark and evil, and all your actions are automatically assumed to be vile and despicable by those who know almost nothing of you, or the long and winding tale of how things came to be as they are, and you came to be who you are. So allow me to begin by assuring you that I am not here to damn you, or even decry you. I am here to offer you a perspective, and a choice. But to do so from a place of loving understanding. Before I might get to this, allow me to say that I know that your only real sin is to be born as you were into the family you were. Between the intense expectations that were placed upon you right from birth, the very specialized training you were subjected to, and the derision that was heaped upon those of your line who did not make the grade, you were programmed right from the very beginning to be what you have become, a wielder of power over others. There are ancillary issues too, such as the fact of your family bloodlines. A pure ancestry that can be traced back through the ages, via all manner of illustrious forebears, right the way to the high priests that served the ancient gods themselves, back when gods still roamed the earth. Perhaps you, yourself, now think on the stories of those ancient times of gods, heroes, magic, and monsters as myth or superstition. Perhaps you understand it to be the literal truth, and know that those ancient gods were actually visitors from other planets in the galaxy, bearing highly advanced technologies. Or perhaps you even take the more religious view of matters, and hold those deities to be as supernatural as your distant forebears did. It doesn't really matter how you interpret these things. What matters is the incontrovertible evidence of the powerful ancient truths that were given to your forebears, and that have been passed down through the generations, which have allowed you to rule over the rest of humanity. Not all of humanity, mind. There have always been groups, peoples, and nations that have been beyond your grasp. But you have been told that it is your birthright, your responsibility, and your privilege to rule over the whole planet, and all upon it. And you have believed that. And it has certainly seemed to be true. The ancient teachings that have been placed in your hands have served you and those like you very well indeed. As has your cunning. Those amongst you who rise to the top are nothing if not brilliantly canny. You have used the advantages placed in your hands very, very astutely. Firstly, for your own benefit, it is true. Then for the benefit of your family, and to ensure the continued ascendancy of your familial line. Then in service of your family's contractual agreements with other bloodline families. And finally, in consideration of the custodial role you have played over the rest of humanity. As matters stand, humanity today is largely blithely unaware of the role you have played, or indeed of your existence. And this is the way you like it. No mob can arrive at the castle gates bearing pitchforks if they don't even know that you exist. So you play your games of power and control from the deep shadows. You cunningly obfuscate your activities. And you slowly expand your reach into every sphere of power and control over all of humanity. And when the sheep stray, you use guile and skill to reclaim the power of direction over them. Perhaps a little war here or there. Or even a very big one. Perhaps a revolution. Perhaps a crash in the stock market. Perhaps even an outbreak of disease. Or a terrorist attack. Or a tsunami of immigrants, to give the populace something to fear. Or, of course, there are always the ever popular bread and circuses. You have certainly made sure that your control of the entertainment industry is ironclad. And there are all manner of complex social nets that you use to make the populace docile and dependent on their government, and therefore upon you. And all such activities are each just a part of your playbook that you use to maintain and increase the control you wield over humanity. You have learned, of course, to offer the sheep the pretense of control over their own destiny. But you know that the real power lies always in your hands. Since no matter how they vote, how they revolt, how they machinate, you and your ilk always get what you want in the end. You have managed a number of glorious victories over the years. Perhaps your crowning achievement is to own the planetary money supply. A nifty trick, I must say. And right now you do, so almost own it all. And he who owns the money of the world, owns the world. Is it not so? And you have also crafted it, so that all the elected officials, that the human flock believe to have the power, must dance when you pull upon their strings. They have become as puppets to your will. Almost all of them. And those that will not willing dance for you, are removed. Or they are shown a film reel, of a brave and proud president. A man of integrity and principle, who dared to stand up to you. And how, in full view of his adoring public, he was assassinated. All this, just before he could begin to undo, your power over the money supply. In the end, all political leaders do your bidding, or they are simply swept away. And the illusion that you grant the sheep, that they can control their destiny through democracy is just that. An illusion. Another nifty trick. And the intelligence agencies. What a truly brilliant move. To elevate spycraft to statecraft. To have the real power behind the politicians, vest in the intelligence agencies. To remove political oversight from those agencies. And then to control them directly yourselves. Why, you can almost step right out of the shadows, and still remain invisible now. The only wrinkle in all of this, as far as I can ascertain, is the internet. Somehow, unexpectedly, a silly little electronic gimmick, of mere academic interest, has suddenly blossomed overnight, into something quite powerful and problematic, has it not? It is due to this very technology, that the sheep are suddenly behaving in quite an unsheep-like fashion. Suddenly they are aware of you. Talking about you. Certainly they are seeing and remarking, upon the curtain that you have drawn around yourselves, if not actually peeking behind the curtain. How irritating this must be. You are on the very cusp of total triumph, and now, at the very last moment, there is this awareness dawning. Your actual names are beginning to be spoken in public forums. People are beginning to see your hands move, on the reins of power. Yes, assuredly, it is still just a fringe that is aware of you, and speaks of you. And yes, you have managed to continue to paint this fringe as lunatics, and crackpots. And, no, this does not threaten your plans and activities. Yet. But you have noticed. You have found the internet to be the greatest threat to your power, and security because, though fragmented and confused, the truth about you certainly is, out there. It can be discerned by any, who would care to look and weigh the evidence. And suddenly, there are sheep that are elevating themselves from the flock. Transmuting themselves into something you have never seen before. Certainly not in such numbers as there now are. And certainly not diffused, as they are, across the whole planet. Previously you could isolate communities of dissidents. Like the Cat Harry. Remember them? They knew the truth. Or at least they held a version of the truth, that was antithetical to your aims. And their teachings were attractive to others. Their message was finding traction. So you used your most powerful pawn at the time, the church, to kill them all. It was a genocide of the most brutal type. Wiping out not only a population, but the very idea that brought them together in unity. Burning all of their books, so that all that is remembered of them now, is what was told by their enemies. And today it is barely even remembered, that one of the Crusades, perhaps the most brutal and bloody of all the Crusades, was not even fought in the Holy Lands, against enemy soldiers, but in France against good Christian folk. Farmers and peasants. Put to the sword, and burned to death, in their churches. All because you could isolate them, round them up, and murder them all. You'll forgive me if I don't applaud. Successful tactics don't always win my approval. And there have been many, 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 such victories that you, the ancient families, have scored over the rest of humanity. They continue today. You wrestle for power, and total control, over the Middle East. which is why things are as they are in that region. Whatever else one thinks about the Islamic religion, is true that they are fundamentally opposed to usury. Which means Muslims will not accept the banking system that you are using to gain worldwide dominance. And so Islam has become a powerful block to your plans. And so you enact your plans. You work to impoverish, torment, and radicalize the Muslim world. You set them up to be the enemy of the Western world. The great terrorists. You control their teachers, and ensure that the message is promulgated, that the West is the great Satan, and you teach the West, that all Muslims are abysmal hate-ridden murderers. And so the wheels are set in motion. And right now a wave of chaos sweeps through Europe, and to one extent or another, the rest of the globe. And this is all a part of your plan. You wish to grind down, and pulverize all of those that stand against your plans. And Muslims are very far from the only ones. And another of your neat tricks, is to set one enemy against another. America was founded upon a principle which was, actually nothing other than open rebellion against your power. America the free. Free from what? From your yoke of control, of course. America's founding principles were, and are directly contrary to your interests. The American Constitution is a truly beautiful document. A document that promises liberty, and freedom for all. But you have whittled, and chaffed, and maneuvered, until you have gained control of the American government, to such an extent that the most powerful military, and technological force in the world, is yours to wield. But as much as your control extends to the American government, the American people are another story altogether. Strong individualists, who continue to believe in their own rights, and liberties, they stand against you at every turn, without even knowing it is you who they resist. So you wage a war of attrition upon them. You seek to ensure that their food, and water is toxified, to weaken them. You use a barrage of techniques of every sort, to manipulate them, and control them. To weaken them, and cow them. And, in a masterstroke of pure genius, you now pit America against Islam. Another truly nifty trick. How very clever of you. I see it. I see it all. And, though I must admit I don't like it, I do understand it. When I look behind your collective activities, choices, and decisions, of the types outlined above, I actually see beings, for whom I have a great deal of compassion and love. I know, as a clear and sure fact, that it is so that you are actually no different than I. The difference is the journey you have walked. Since all is truly one, you are the part of that one great eternal spirit, that has walked your path, just as I am another part of that same great being, that has walked my path. My path leads to where I am, unified within the heart of the Pleiadian monad. Your path leads you to be incarnated, as a human being, bearing the mantle and the burden, of being a member of one of the ancient families upon the earth. And those amongst humanity, who are aware of you, and judge you most harshly, do so purely out of a lack of self-knowledge. Place them in your situation, and they too would do as you have done. Or worse. And I know too that what you do to another, you do to yourself also. So I don't envy you the results of your choices. But your story is not over. You are not done with your journey. In due course you too will arise spiritually, and begin to return to oneness, with your own spiritual entity. Because there is nowhere else for you to go, really. And this is beginning to happen for some of your family members. Perhaps you have noticed those members, who don't seem to be quite so committed to the old cause. Those who seem to be getting soft. Those who seem to be talking crazy talk, about abdicating their power. About telling the sheep the truth. Indeed, those who actually have been finding ways to communicate these truths to humanity, using that very despised technology, the internet. Is it strange that those amongst you, who are proposing this new course of openness and transparency, this course of abdication of power, are also those amongst you, who are most interested in matters, metaphysical and spiritual? I propose this is not in the least bit strange. It takes an interest in metaphysics, and spirituality, to discern that a new age is now already dawning. That the time of your watching over humanity is at an end. Indeed, that it is ending without the return of your master, your dark god king. And that there is no longer any real hope that he ever will return. You are on your own. Your secret prophecies have come to naught. And it takes an interest in metaphysics and spirituality to see that there is a changing of the guard happening. That there is a new spiritual order beginning. That those who govern this reality, from the very highest levels, from the angelic realms down, are busy changing hands. That is what the new dawning age is all about. And that is why you stand at a fork in the road. It is why you must now choose. But before I tell you, at last, about the choice you face, I will tell you one final thing, something you most certainly will have noticed. Because it takes no special awareness, or training, in either spirituality, or metaphysics, to see that your magic is beginning to fail you. Irrespective of what you believe, the real source of your power to be, you will have noticed that it is waning fast. It becomes more and more difficult by the day, for you to wield your power. Plug a little leak here, and the dam wall springs a gushing fissure over there. The game that seemed elegant, and nearly effortless for generations past, is causing you, and those like you, to raise a real sweat. It is a constant struggle to maintain control. You are feeling the stress of this night and day. And it feels as if you are losing your grip. Just as you near victory, so things become ever more impossibly challenging. The magic becomes unstable. You certainly will have noticed this. Just look at the process of taking ownership of the world money supply. It was almost effortless to enact the stroke of genius that floated money free from the gold standard. And since then, it has been a minor effort to bring the nations of the world, one by one, into this fiat banking system, which is really money by decree. Your decree. Money is now mere numbers that mean whatever you say they mean. But the magic trick is not complete until every nation is a part of it. And so you have used the leverage you had to expand your control until almost every last nation has fallen under your sway. The very last few holdouts exist. You have them isolated and on the ropes. They are almost ready to be taken and controlled. But right here at the very last, you find yourselves losing grip here, there, and everywhere. You find your attention being constantly diverted by all manner of seemingly trivial, but irritating, diversions. And in concert, your energy and attention is so diverted that you can never quite act to gain total power. And this global money supply beast that belongs to you seems to have a malevolent life of its own, in that the larger it becomes, the more difficult it is to control. My friends, what you must understand is that planet Earth does not exist in a vacuum. We have kept it quarantined so that humanity, as a whole, can decide its own fate. But it has been in a state of physical quarantine. We have kept other galactic civilizations from interfering physically. But there has been no spiritual quarantine. And so a small, but powerful contingent of star seeds and light bringers have been born amongst the planet's populace. And they have utterly altered the consciousness upon the planet. They have, by the simple fact of their presence upon the Earth, brought a new awareness to the Earth. And they come in now with higher and higher levels of consciousness. They accelerate and amplify these changes upon the planet. You can neither stop, nor slow, nor alter the course of these changes. Humanity will awaken. Humanity will come to self-awareness. Humanity will make a choice, collectively, about its own nature. This is divinely ordained. It is the dawning of the new age. And it is very soon to happen. The window of opportunity reached its midpoint in 2012. It is beginning to close. And before it does, humanity will have decided. You, my dear friends, are the watchers over the old order. To you fell the task of shepherding humanity through the long dark age of forgetting. Humanity needed a guiding hand that would work constantly to make order out of the chaos, as they slowly let go of the old gods, as they slowly healed themselves, of the traumas of being playthings, to the darker of the old gods, and abject supplicants to the more kindly of the old gods. You have played a crucial role. You have provided order and structure. You have provided leadership and direction. You have done all of this without actually being anything other than the same human beings, of the same earth, as those over whom you ruled. Yes, it is true, that you have your familial bloodlines. But, in truth, that is nothing more than a very exclusive club, to which you belong. You are, genetically, no more special than the rest of humanity, which some of you like to call, mongrel humans. You are not in any meaningful way biologically superior to them. A purebred dog might have many excellent, and desirable attributes, but a mutt is more robust, and less prone to specific health issues. And so it is for you and the rest of humanity. And you are certainly not spiritually superior either. What you do have is ancient knowledge, specialized training, and a vast network of control. And now you also have a choice. On the one hand, you can choose to fight the divinely ordained order. You can resist the changing of the ages. And you can be ground under in pain, and self-destruction, as you fight the absolute inevitable. Or you can embrace the change, and, in so doing, be a part of something beautiful, new, and glorious. Indeed, such are the times right now that you could, if you so choose, step right out of the shadows, and into the light. You could emerge as a bright beacon of the light. You could move from semi-reviled obscurity, into loved and revered glory. You could. It is up to you. Or you could remain attached to that which is passing away. You could fight tooth and nail to the bitter end, and know only bitter defeat. You could find yourself in a physical, emotional, and spiritual dead end, with your life over, and nowhere to reincarnate, to that would accept both you and your choices. You could find yourself in the depths of the void, racked in spiritual torment. It is all up to you. I offer you this choice now, not because I need you to decide any particular way. Neither I, nor my starseed family, nor the greater humanity, of which I am so fond, will be overly affected by your choice. The difference between your choosing this way, or that will, in the greater scheme of things, be small. All of humanity will weather the storm that comes, and will come to the awakening moment, and will make their choice, irrespective of what you do or don't do. That is utterly foreordained. The new age will begin, irrespective of your choices and actions. What you choose matters little enough for them. But it matters greatly for you. I point you towards this choice, out of compassion for you. I do so only because, were I in your shoes, I would wish to be alerted to this choice at this crucial juncture. So, in practical terms, what are the choices I am advocating, and what might the outcome of those choices be for you? My dear friends, I am suggesting to you that you begin by learning to listen to your hearts. I don't mean your physical heart, or your emotional heart. I mean your spiritual heart. This is where you connect with the same great oneness, to which we all belong. If you listen to your spiritual heart, you will find that there is guidance and wisdom there. Your heart can lead you in making the best possible choices that serve the greatest good of the all. If you are not able to hear your heart, you can choose to find someone who can teach you how. Xing Dad is one of many upon the earth right now, teaching exactly this skill. Or you can do the right things, that will lead you on the right path, that will result in your spiritual heart opening. In specific, in your circumstance, you can ask yourself, what can I do right now, that will open the doors for the rest of humanity, to greater awareness and understanding of their situation? What can I do right now, to create fewer secrets and more transparency? What can I do right now, to give humanity greater choice, and self-empowerment? What can I do right now, to foster greater peace, harmony, compassion, and understanding? What can I do right now to smooth the transition to the new dawning age? How can I increase the quotient of love in the world? How can I decrease the quotient of suffering in the world? These are the kinds of questions that you should be answering for yourself, if you wish to participate in the changes that are afoot. Engaging yourself with this process will cause you to find your energetic heart. It will allow you to know the sweet taste of being loved for who you are, as much as for what you do. You will feel the hand of divine guidance in your heart. And as you do this, so you will also find yourself beginning to be able to forgive yourself for all that you have done in the past. You will find, eventually, that you are able to forgive your whole line of forebears for all that they have done through the ages. And you will be surprised by the capacity others will have to forgive you and your line. Comprehension and compassion will dawn. And, for so long as you are motivated by love, the hand of divine protection will be over you, as this process unfolds. Engage with this process, heart and soul, and there need be no negative repercussion at all. You can pay the price of the burden of your choices in love, rather than in suffering and pain. But you must choose to do so. And if you do, you will find yourself transitioning to the new earth, with the rest of humanity that has also chosen this. If you wish it, your skills at administration and management might be put to magnificent purpose. You might find yourself in great demand, in a position of revered leadership. Or, indeed, you might choose for that quiet, peaceful, gentle life in that beautiful corner of the world that you have always secretly hankered after, but never believed you could settle down to. It is all up to you. The point, really, is that you will find yourself blessed with an abundance of very attractive options if you should choose to be guided by love. And this contrasts sharply with the optionless, self-destructive, dead end that lies at the end of the road if you should continue to choose from a place of closed-hearted fear. And this is what I needed to share with you at this point. I know that all of you who are ready for this message will receive it, as we have ways to ensure this. And I also wanted to share this letter to you in the most open fashion possible, since part of the healing that is being made available to humanity will come from their understanding that you are not as other as they would have thought. Until they can see themselves in your position, you will struggle to break down the boundaries. And in this letter, by the way I address you, they can see that you are not some kind of demonic enemy. That you are humans as they are. That you are lost and hurt as they are. That you have made the same kinds of choices, out of your fear and pain, as they have. That you can come to heal yourself, forgive yourself, and love yourself, as they might. And that greater good flowers for you when you do so, just as it does for them. And finally, I wish humanity to see that you actually did as was required of you. You held the helm in the vacuum left when the old gods departed. You did so for the whole age of forgetting. And that, ultimately, was what you contracted for. With love and compassion, I leave you now to your choices. Thank you for watching. Please help spread the word and make a difference by sharing and subscribing for more thought-provoking content, and give us a thumbs up if you liked the video. Your support is greatly appreciated. Be aware and stay safe.